people who are acquainted with the history of great composers know that most of them were certifiable madmen. Johann Sebastian Bach first became famous when he got into a sword fight with one of his students in the orchestra. He accused a bassoonist of sounding like a nanny goat when he played. The ensuing violence promoted him to fame throughout Germany. Beethoven was well known for throwing eggs at his housekeepers and doing other quite unmentionable things. And even up until the time of Brahms, well, his personality can be summed up with one simple anecdote. He was at a party in Vienna, and as he left, he turned to the door and said, "If there's anyone here I've neglected to offend, I humbly apologize." So why was it that the American composers were such great guys? George Gershwin lived a short life, a tragically short life, but in that time, you have a very hard time finding anybody who said anything negative about him. And he had dozens of girlfriends, so he was doing something right. At any rate, he succeeded in his death because his music, which he wanted to enter the concert world, has now entered it on many levels. And I actually wanted to just play for you a couple of examples of what a classical pianist does with Gershwin's timeless songs. So these are the melodies you know as Embraceable You and I Got Rhythm.